Good afternoon. I'm Mike Freeman, Hennepin County Attorney, and I'm here with Revenue Commissioner Cynthia Bowerly. Collectively, we are announcing a 53-count complaint against Rona Estelle Griffin for filing false and fraudulent tax returns on behalf of a number of individuals. Not only did she file false tax returns for her clients, she failed to file tax returns for herself. Can you imagine a tax returner not preparing a tax return for herself or her business? There are 53 counts, including a final theft by swindle account. There are 10 people reflected who were cheated in the complaint. There are many more we believe were defrauded. This is a result of some superb work by the Department of Revenue's investigators and auditors who are behind me here. We thank them for their fine work. We believe this is the largest tax fraud case filed by this office in its history. It's not the only one. We filed a number over a period of time, and we have two pending now. But this is a result of brazen cheating and some very diligent investigating. And, you know, we attorneys can do our jobs when investigators do their job. And they certainly have done it today. And Commissioner, we're very thankful.
Thank you. Thank you, County Attorney Freeman. Thank you for your partnership and cooperation with us on this case. We take these crimes very seriously and appreciate our local law enforcement partners as they help us pursue these crimes across the state. Taxpayers and trust preparers with their personal information and their money. They deserve fair representation, not fraud. We work to ensure that everyone, including tax preparers, follow the laws, and we take our role in that very seriously at the Department of Revenue. Taxpayers looking for help in choosing a preparer can find great tips on our website. I'd like to talk for just a moment about what this investigation looked like at the Department of Revenue. We began to notice a pattern with this particular preparer and the returns that she filed on behalf of Minnesota taxpayers. We conducted a couple of hundred of audits to investigate what was happening here. Those patterns and the result of those audits led us to open a criminal investigation, which was conducted by our criminal investigation division, in particular Gary Charbonneau, and that division is led by Director Sarah Wesley. And they've done great work in this case, and we thank them for that. We then worked with our local law enforcement partner here and a great team here at the county attorney's office to prepare these charges for filing today. As I mentioned, this is an important charge because it brings these alleged charges will bring justice to this particular individual and to the taxpayers for whom she was working and allegedly defrauding. But it's also an important reminder because it is tax filing season, and for people who are looking for a tax preparer, we want them to use caution and some discretion in choosing their tax preparer. We have information available on the Department of Revenue's website. If you put choosing a tax preparer into the search term, you will find tips and questions that we suggest you ask when choosing a tax preparer to ensure that you are getting the best service possible. For individuals who qualify, there are also free assistance sites available to low-income and senior folks to get help in person with preparing your taxes. So we encourage people to be vigilant with their information, particularly their tax information. And this is an example of one individual tax preparer who obviously has engaged in allegedly criminal activity. There are many qualified tax preparers in Minnesota, and this shouldn't be taken as a representation of what happens with the preparer community. We work very well with them, and this is an instance of a allegedly very bad apple in amongst a bunch of fine preparers in the state of Minnesota. Thank you very much.
Questions? The commissioner can talk about the office, the investigation, and I'll try to talk about the legal proceedings.
My commission, there are hundreds of clients this tax preparer had, many or most had problems with this tax preparer. Do you have like a bit more clear number on how many people this woman served?
We think there are over hundreds for which she has prepared inaccurate and false tax returns. For our purposes, there are 10 here because she prepared over several years on a number of them. We also have about 10 counts for when she failed to file her own tax returns, not only for herself, but for her business, and then a theft for swindle. And that count is basically, we believe she swindled good, hardworking folks out of their money. They paid to have a proper tax return prepared, and they got a piece of junk. So we think that fits within theft by swindle, and so that's the last account.
If she was manipulating other people's returns and submitting them, how was she actually making money? How did the money come to her?
We think the swindle was she charged people to do the taxes. She did them wrong. She knew she was doing them wrong. She knew she was overinflating things like charitable contributions, things like unreimbursed business expenses. And so though they technically got an account done for kind of a bargain price, their money was taken because she did it wrong, and now they're having to pay the back taxes with interest. And that's not much fun.
You said you had two pending cases. I know you can't talk about the specifics. The dollar amount's potentially larger than this case?
You know, David, I think this is the largest that we've done. We have two, we got a guilty plea from Susan Beeman in the Envy Owners case for failure to remit sales tax from her bar receipts. And Michael Whitelaw has been charged with 68 counts of underreporting income and therefore sales tax to the state, perhaps $100,000 worth, and his next hearing is February 17th. So we got one that's done and one that's pending.
Neither you or the commissioner, obviously an incredible amount of resources has to go into nailing a case like this. Can you even give a breadth of hours and manpower and costs that also will cost the taxpayers on some?
Absolutely. So the department's investigation really starts in our individual audit income division. And so we start to look at, we have a sophisticated system that relies on technology and human capital to identify patterns that are suspicious or concerning. And then our audit teams work those through, and then again, where there is a case of severity, then it's turned over to our criminal investigation division. So there are significant department resources in that, in terms of both highly trained, highly skilled, and highly dedicated auditors, and as well in our investigation team. We don't have a calculation in terms of hours, but again, these are resources that the state has dedicated to making sure that this can be prosecuted.
Months long is safe, though, several months easily.
We began this investigation in 2012, and with the returns that were coming in then, and so it has been not a full-time job for each of those individuals, but certainly significant resources over the last 2 years.
Is this the largest from your end? I know it's the largest his office has prosecuted. Have you seen bigger fraud cases?
It is certainly a significant set, and if I could follow up with you on whether this is in terms of either dollar amount or individuals, I'd be happy to do that.
Thank you.
Can you go back to what was the red flag for your office that made you go, we need to look more into this, we need to investigate?
Sure. So again, we have a system that can detect patterns, irregularities, and then those get further review. And we're not going to get into specifics of how we go about doing that. Those are some of our techniques internal to the agency. But it really, instances get flagged, and they could certainly just be simple errors by a particular person, or they could really lead us to something much larger.
Mike, just one more, reimbursement somehow, is that on the table trying to get any of the money?
Well, the individuals, I think the department, I want to speak for the commissioner, is dealing with each individual fairly. They owe interest, and I presume they're making payment plans for some who can't write the check. We have not, nor do we plan to initiate any criminal proceedings against individuals because we think they're all defrauded. If you're asking the question of restitution, the entity that was cheated would be due restitution to the state of Minnesota. And we don't normally do that. It's not saying we can't do that, but we normally don't do that. Okay? Thank you all very much.